In this video, we'll introduce an exciting new functionality coming to Carbonite Server Backup called Rapid VM Restore, or RVMR. In short, RVMR allows restoring a virtual machine backup to a fully functional state in a matter of minutes, regardless of the size of the VM. This drastically reduces your RTO in a disaster recovery scenario, and allows you to live migrate the recovered VM back to any permanent storage at a more convenient time. Furthermore, you can continue backing up the RVMR with Carbonite Server Backup before and after migrating it to permanent storage, ensuring that data protection on the VM doesn't lapse. We'll demonstrate how this all works and what it looks like, but first, we'll touch on a few requirements for RVMR. The vSphere Recovery Agent, or VRA, must have .NET 4.5 installed, and an iSCSI target must be installed via Server Manager. The RVMR feature must also be enabled in Director. More details, including supported operating systems, can be found in our written documentation. For context, let's quickly look at our demo cluster in vSphere. We have two ESX servers that will serve as targets for our RVMR restores. Any existing storage location can be used as the initial temporary restore location for RVMR. The only requirement is that you must have more than two storage locations in your environment for RVMR. We also have a Windows and Linux VM with successful full backups that we'll be restoring from. And we have a demo VRA to facilitate the restore. Just remember that each of these have a series of setup requirements detailed in our documentation that must be in place before an RVMR is available. Okay, now let's perform a rapid VM restore. In Portal, click the Computers tab. Then open the cluster with the VM backup you need to restore. In the Action dropdown next to the desired VM, select Restore. And in this screen, select Virtual Machine using Rapid VM Restore. This option only shows when all setup requirements are met. Next, we'll configure the RVMR. You can choose to restore from an alternate safe set by clicking the calendar icon here and entering your encryption password. If there are multiple VMs to restore from, you can select one here, then enter your encryption password. Under Data Store, I'm going to select one of the restore locations I had identified earlier. Then select an available server as the destination host. The restore is set to automatically power on the VM and connect it to the network after restoring, but you can uncheck either option here if desired. Then click Run Restore. After briefly loading, you'll see that the Rapid VM Restore is starting. While we're waiting for it to complete, I'll point out the Cancel Rapid VM Restore option here. This is a single button click to cancel the process and reverse all the automatic actions taken to set up the RVMR. This option stays available while the RVMR is running and can be selected at any time. In a matter of minutes, you'll see the status change to Rapid VM Restore is running. Once you see this status, your RVMR is fully functional and ready to use. This is all you have to do to perform a Rapid VM Restore. But let's look back in vSphere to see what's happening in a little more detail. We can see that there's a new VM in the cluster here. This is our restored VM backup, and it's running just like any other VM would be. In this demonstration, the RVMR is restored as a copy since the original VM still exists in the cluster. In a scenario like this, you can still continue backing up the RVMR with Carbonite Server Backup by creating a new backup job or adding it to an existing backup job. In scenarios when the original VM is not present, the RVMR will restore the VM with the original UUID, and any existing backup jobs for the VM will continue to work seamlessly on the RVMR. From Portal, you can tell when a backup job is currently working as a Rapid VM Restore by the spinning icon here. You can click this icon to reveal the status of the RVMR. We'll look closer at migrating an RVMR shortly, but first, let's demonstrate how you can run multiple RVMRs at once. Simply perform all the same steps with another VM backup job. This time, we'll restore the Linux VM. Remember that the Virtual Machine Using Rapid VM Restore option only appears when all requirements are met. After the Linux RVMR is launched, we can go back to vSphere to see that the Linux VM has already been added to the cluster. And our Windows VM from before can be powered on, logged into, and used like any other VM, all in a matter of minutes. Now that we've seen just how quickly a Rapid VM Restore can get you up and running, let's demonstrate migrating a VM to permanent storage. This is necessary to do at some point, as VM performance in a rapid restore scenario is not as good as a VM in a live environment. But you can work with an RVMR and plan the migration for a convenient time. Back in Portal, click the spinning RVMR icon to bring up the status window. Then click Migrate VM. When migrating, Portal assumes that your host is already configured, so all you have to do is select the desired data store and click Start Migration. The status will change to VM Migration is in progress. This process will take some time, and larger VMs will take longer. The rest of the migration process will happen automatically for you from here, but can be canceled at any time before completion by clicking Cancel Migration. This would halt the copy of the VM to permanent storage and leave the RVMR running. In vSphere, we can see that our RVMR is working on a new Relocate Virtual Machine task, which was triggered by the migration. When the migration finishes, Carbonite Server Backup handles all the cleanup operations as well. The next time you open the status window, you'll see the migration has finished. Close the window and the spinning icon goes away. This VM is now in permanent storage and you can pick back up where you left off without missing a beat. We hope you found this demonstration for Rapid VM Restore helpful. For more information and details, please search our online knowledge base for Rapid VM Restore.